In the last lecture, we have discussed about theorems on probability. In this section, we shall discuss on random variable and their nature and types. For introduction, the outcome of a random experiment may be numerical or non-numerical in nature. For example, the number of telephone calls received in a board in 1 hour is numerical in nature. By the result of coin tossing experiment, in which 2 coins are tossed at a time, is non-numerical in nature. Because if we tossing 2 coins, our outcomes in either head-head or head-tail or tail-head or tail and tail, which is non-numerical in nature. So as it often useful to describe the outcome of random experiment by a number, we will assign a number to every non-numerical outcome of the experiment. For example, in tossing of 2 coins, we can assign the value 0 to outcome of getting 2 tails, 1 to the outcome of getting 1 head and 1 tail, which is these 2 events, and 2 to the outcome of getting 2 heads, which is first event. Thus, in any experimental situation, we can assign a number x to every element s of the sample space, and that is x s is equal to x match the elements of sample space into real numbers is called random variable. So random variable is a number which are associated with outcome of an experiment. Now, the formal definition may be defined as follows. A random variable x is a function that assigns a real number x s to every element of the sample space corresponding to the random experiment. That is, x is a function defined from sample space to a real number, and the function maps the element of sample space into real numbers is called random variables. And real number, we can separate real numbers in 2 different. First one is discrete random variable, real number can be separated in 2 forms. First is discrete numbers, and second, continuous real numbers. In discrete number, there are 2 types of numbers exist. First one is countably finite. First, countable, and second, countably infinite. So discrete number is either countable or countably. Countably infinite means countable but tends to infinite or goes to infinity. For example, natural number. Natural numbers started from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on and goes up to infinity. So natural number is countably infinite number. And continuous number means a number which can assume any value in the given certain interval. For example, x lies between 1 to 2. So there are infinite numbers between 1 to 2, real numbers, and x lies in this interval, known as continuous real numbers. So there are 2 types of random variables. First one is discrete random variable and second is continuous random variable. According to their name, the discrete random variable is if x is a random variable which can take finite number or countably infinite number of the values, then x is called discrete random variable. For example, in a dice throwing experiment in which 2 dice are thrown at a time, sum of the number on the uppermost face of the dice is a discrete random variable, because in this case x denotes sum of the number on 2 dice, and sum of the minimum number 1 plus 1 is 2 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So there are, the values are discrete, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and countable. So such random variable known as discrete random variable. And this is the example of finite number, which can take finite number of the values, and so the given function or given random variable is known as discrete random variable. When a discrete random variable or a random variable is discrete, the possible values of x may be assumed as x1, x2, x3 to xn and tends to infinity. In the finite case, the list of the values terminates, and in the countably infinite case, list goes up to infinity. In the previous case, the values of the random variable is finite. So this is the first example, the sum values of terminate, which is more than 12. For example, of countable infinite case, the number of failure preceding the first success in infinite series of independent prior, where the probability of success is fixed. In this experiment, the random variable x denotes number of failure preceding the first success. So outcomes may become in the form no failure, which means in the first trial success, or in zero failure preceding the first success. Second possibility, one failure and then success. So one, two failure and then success. So two failure preceding the first success, there are number random variable assume 2. And similarly for three failure preceding the first success, and this is goes up to infinity. So this is the example of countable infinite case, and random variable is assume discrete values. So if a random variable is discrete, then that random variable assume either count infinite number or countably infinite numbers. Now the next definition is probability mass function related to discrete random variable. If x is a random variable which can take the values x1, x2, x3 to xn and so on, such that probability of xi is equal to pi, then pi is called probability mass function or point probability function or only probability function, provided pi satisfied the following conditions. First condition, in each case pi is always greater than or equal to 0 for every value of I, and second, summation over I of probability mass function is equal to 1. So if these two conditions are satisfied, then such function known as probability mass function or point probability function. And collection of xi and pi, I vary from 1, 2, 3, 2 and so on, is called probability distribution of random variable. And probability distribution of a random variable x can be displayed in tabular form, where first column represent the number of random variable of represent random variable, and second column represent probability of this random variable. So x1, x2, x3 to xn, and p1, p2, p3, pn and so on. For example, if x denote the number of heads in a coin tossing experiment in which 3 coins are tossed at a time. So in this case, number of heads in a coin tossing experiment in which 3 coins are tossed at a time. So x assume 0, no heads, 1 heads, 2 heads and 3 heads maximum. So first we find outcomes of the random experiment. So in a coin tossing, three coin tossing, three heads, two head and tail, tail, head, head and head, tail, head, tail, tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, tail, tail, and all three tails. These are possible outcomes in case of when we throwing three coins. Now, x denote random variable 0, 1, 2, and 3. Now, probability of x equal to x, which is probability of x equal to 0 means no head. There are only one outcome in which no head. So, out of 8, so 1 by 8 is the probability of x equal to 0. In second case, probability of x equal to 1, which means probability of exactly one head. Exactly one head in three cases, which are first tail, head, and tail, 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 and head, tail, and tail. So there are three favorable outcomes out of eight possible outcomes. So probability of x equal to 1 is 3 by 8. Similarly, for probability of x equal to 2, which means exactly 2 head, head, head and tail, tail, head, 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 tail and head. There are 3 favorable outcomes out of 8. So probability of exactly 2 head is 3 by 8. And in last case, all 3 heads, there are only 1 favorable case. So probability of exactly 3 head is equal to 1 by 8. Now, given function is probability function or not? So first, probability mass function PMF satisfied the condition. In each case, probability is always greater than 0. Here PI is always greater than or equal to 0 for every value of I. First condition are satisfied. Now second condition is summation over I probability mass function is equal to 1. So in this case, P1 plus P2 plus P3, I vary from 1 to, so 0 to 3. So P0, P1, P2 and P3, sum of this 1 by 8 plus 3 by 8 plus 3 by 8 plus 1 by 8, which is equal to 1 8 by 8. So given function is a probability mass function and assume discrete value. So discrete random variable. The next example in which the function is PMF or not. Check whether the following function is probability mass function or not. In the first example, question, probability of x equal to x is equal to x minus 2 by 2, where x varies from 1 to 4. X can assume 4 values, 1, 2, 3 and 4. First we find probability distribution of the given function. So x equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Probability of x equal to x is, for probability of x equal to 1, we put x equal to 1 in the given function, 1 minus 2 upon 2 minus 1 by 2. For 2, 2 minus 2, 0, 0 by 2 is equal to 0. When x equal to 3, 3 minus 2, so result is probability of x equal to 3 is 1 by 2. And for 4, 4 minus 2 by 2 is equal to 1. So now, as probability of x equal to 1 is equal to minus half, not is greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, given function not serve as probability mass function. We can abbreviate probability mass function as PMF. Though the second condition are satisfied in this case, because of minus half, plus 0, plus half, plus 1 is equal to 1. But first condition are not satisfied, so given function is not a probability mass function. or cannot serve as a probability mass function. Now, similarly in second case, probability of capital X equal to X is equal to X square by 25 and X vary from 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So, probability distribution of given random variable X, which can assume 1, 2, 3 and 4 value, and their probability distribution is given by probability of X equal to 1. In this case 1 by 25, x equal to 2, then 4 by 25, x equal to 3, and 9 by 25, and in last case 16 by 25. So given function is a probability mass function or not? First condition is for every value of x, pi is greater than or equal to 0, and therefore first condition are satisfied for every x equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now, second condition, total probability of random variable x is equal to 0, equal to should be 1, and in this case 1 by 25 plus 4 by 25 plus 9 by 25 plus 16 by 25 is equal to 25 plus 30 by 25, which is greater than 1. So second condition not satisfied in this case, and therefore function is not a probability mass function, because second condition of the which is total of the probability is equal to 1 not satisfied, and it is greater than and equal to 1. So if both these conditions are satisfied in any function, then such function known as probability mass function. Now we move to continuous random variable. According to the name continuous random variable, if x is a random variable which can take all values, that is infinite number of the values in a certain interval, then x called a continuous random variable. In other words, a random variable is said to be continuous when its different values cannot be put into one-to-one correspondence with the set of positive integers. And a continuous random variable is a random variable that can be measured and to any desired degree of the accuracy. Example of continuous random variable, which are age, height, weight of any person or a group of persons, and which are continuous, example of continuous random variables. Now the important note related to continuous, in case of continuous random variable, the number of events indefinitely large, because in any certain interval there exist, like 0 to 1, there exist infinite numbers. And probability that a particular event, that a particular number like half occurs is 1 by 2 divided by infinity, which is equal to practically 0. So in this case, here instead of finding probability at a particular value of x, we find the probability of x falling in the small or very small interval. The next definition, which is related to continuous random variable, function related to continuous random variable, known as probability density function, or we can abbreviate PDF, probability density function. If x is a continuous random variable such that probability of x greater than x minus dx by 2 and less than equal to x plus dx by 2, which is x fall in a small interval dx, is equal to function of x dx, where function of x dx represent the probability that x falls in the extremely small interval x minus dx by 2 to x plus dx by 2. Then function of x is called probability density function of x provided function of x satisfies following conditions. First condition, function of x always greater than or equal to 0 for every value of range space or x varying from or x is greater than minus infinity to less than infinity. And in second condition, integration over the interval minus infinity to infinity over the range space is equal to 1. Here function of x represent a probability curve, and this is a probability curve, and x fall in a small interval dx is represented by this. So probability of x lies in dx, x minus dx by 2 and greater than x plus dx by 2 is equal to integration over x minus dx by 2. This is starting point of this strip, x minus dx by 2, and this part x plus dx by 2. Function of x probability curve. So area under the curve is always equal to 1, which is the second condition. And now function of x is a very small value in this interval, so treating as a constant value. And if function of x is constant in this interval, then outside the integration sign, and x minus dx by 2 and x plus dx by 2 integration with respect to x. So function of x, integration of dx, x minus dx by 2 to x plus dx by 2. X plus dx by 2 minus x minus dx by 2. So in this case, x cancelled by x, and function of x dx, which is result of probability function, which represent the probability that x falls in extremely small interval, and function of x called PDF or probability density function, if these two conditions are satisfied in this case. Because of function of x is a probability curve, so function is always greater than or equal to 0, and total area under the curve, probability curve, is equal to 1, because probability is not more than 1 in any case. The probability for a variate value to lie in the interval dx is fx dx and hence the probability for a variate value to fall in the finite interval ab is given by probability of x greater than or equal to b and less than or equal to b is equal to integration of function of x with respect to x over the interval ab. So important remark related to continuous random variable or probability density function. In case of discrete and discrete random variable, in case of discrete random variable, the probability at a point is not equal to 0 for some fixed value of c. However, in case of continuous random variable, the probability at a point is always 0. That is, probability at x equal to c is 0. If we put a equal to b equal to c in the above example, probability of x is greater than a and less than b, c to c function of x dx is always equal to 0 because of upper and lower limits are same, and therefore integration is equal to 0. So this property of continuous random variable, which is probability of x equal to c equal to 0 for every c, leads the following results. In this case, all these probabilities are always remain same, and it does not matter whether we include the endpoint of the interval from a to b. So probability of x greater than or equal to b or less than equal to b is equal to probability of x greater than a or less than equal to b is equal to probability of x greater than equal to n less than b, and this all three probabilities are equal to probability of x greater than a and less than b. Extreme points are not included. Both extreme points are not included in this case. In this case, right hand side extreme point not included, and in this case left side extreme point are not included. Now, cumulative distribution function. In the both the cases, discrete and continuous random variable, we define cumulative distribution function. If x is a random this random variable, discrete or continuous, then probability of x less than equal to x is called cumulative distribution function or only distribution function of x, and denoted by capital F of x. If x is discrete, then cumulative distribution function is equal to summation over j, where xj is always less than equal to x, pj. And if x is continuous, then integration of limit of the integration varies from minus infinity to x, and integration over dx. Properties of cumulative distribution function. It is clear that f of x is non-degenerating decreasing function or increasing function of x. Cumulative function cumulative distribution function is less than minus infinity is always equal to 0, because of if we integrate minus infinity to minus infinity of probability density function, then this becomes 0 because limits are same. Similarly, cumulative distribution function is less than infinity, where x is, which means probability of x less than or equal to infinity is equal to minus infinity to infinity function of x dx, is a complete region under the probability curve. So total probability regression is equal to 1. Now, third property, if x is a discrete random variable, taking the values x equal to x1, x2, x3 to xn, where x1, x2, x3 to xn, xn minus 1, and so on. Pnx, probability of xn is equal to cumulative distribution function till xn minus probability of, sorry, cumulative distribution function of xn minus 1. It shows that probability of xn less than equal to x, so x is less than equal to xn, minus probability of x is less than equal to xn minus 1. Naturally, this is equal to probability of xn. The next and important property for continuous random variable is, if community function is differentiable, then we can find probability density function if we know cumulative distribution function. By differentiating cumulative distribution function with respect to x, now example related to continuous random variable, find the value k so that function of x may be a probability density function of random variable x for the value x lies between 0 to 2. So given function is function of x equal to kx 2 minus x, where x lies in interval 0 to 2. So given function is a probability density function, then first condition is function of x is always greater than or equal to 0 for every value of x. So x lies between 0 to 2. If you put x equal to 0, we get function of x equal to 0. And if we put 2, then all function of x is always greater. So for every x greater than 0 and less than 2, function of x greater than or equal to 0. In second condition, integration over the interval or range space 0 to 2, function of dx, function of x, integration with respect to dx is always equal to 1. So applying this condition, we will find the value of k. We put 0 to 2, function of x, k, x2 minus x, integration with respect to x is equal to 1. This implies that k is a constant, 2x integration of, so 2 into x square by 2 minus integration of x square, x cube by 3, and limit 0 to 2 is equal to 1. Now we put our upper limit, so 4 x square, 2 square 4 minus 8 by 3 to cube a, and in case of lower limit both the values tends to 0 is equal to 1. So 4 by 3 equal to 1, and this implies that k equal to 3 by 4. So for if k equal to 3 by 4, then the given function is a probability density function in the given interval, otherwise not a probability density function. In the second example, a continuous random variable x has the distribution function or cumulative distribution. So cumulative distribution function given in the question, and we want to find the value of k for which given function is a cumulative distribution function or probability density function, and second find the probability density function. So if f of x is continuous, then probability density function given by differentiation of cumulative distribution function with respect to x. So if x is less than or equal to 1, function of x or probability density function of x is equal to 0, because of for x is less than or equal to 2, cumulative distribution function is 0. If x greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 3, then probability density function f of x is differentiation of cumulative distribution function, which is k into x minus 1 whole raised to the power 4. Differentiation of the k is a constant, 4x minus 1 whole raised to the power 3. And if x is greater than 3, cumulative distribution function fx is equal to 1, and therefore probability density function in this interval is equal to differentiation of cumulative distribution function, which is 1, is equal to 0, because differentiation of a constant value is equal to 0. And so probability density function is equal to only existing interval x is greater than 1 and less than equal to 0, and in remaining interval or remaining values of x, function of x becomes 0. So we can write 4k x minus 1 whole cube when x is greater than 1 and less than equal to 3 and 0 as well. So first part is complete. The second part is probability density function of function of cumulative distribution function, which is a continuous function. So differentiation of this cumulative distribution function with respect to x in different interval. First, x is less than or equal to 1, function of x, cumulative distribution function in this case is equal to 0, so their differentiation is necessarily 0. In second interval, where x is greater than 1 and less than or equal to 3, cumulative distribution function is k into x minus 1 whole raised to the power 4, and which is a algebraic function, and algebraic function is always a continuous function. So probability density function in this interval is equal to differentiation of cumulative distribution function with respect to x. We get function of x equal to 4k x minus 1 whole cube. And in last interval, where x is greater than 3, cumulative distribution function is equal to 1. Therefore, probability density function is equal to 0 because of differentiation of a constant value is always 0. And therefore, probability density function of given random variable is 4k x minus 1 whole cube when x is greater than 1 and less than equal to 3 and 0 elsewhere. Now we find the value of k by definition of probability density function or condition of probability density function. If given function is a probability density function, then integration over the range space, which is 1 to 3 of probability density function 4k 1 minus x whole raised to the power 3 dx is always equal to 1. So integration of this function, 4k is a constant, x minus 1 whole raised to the power 4 by 4 over the limit 1 to 3 is equal to 1. And this implies that 4k, if you put x equal to 3, upper limit 3 minus 2, so 4 cancel by 4, and 2 to the power 4, 16. And if you put 1, 1 minus 1, 0, so minus 0 equal to 1, and therefore k equal to 1 by 16. And finally, probability density function f of x equal to 4k x minus 1 whole cube, which means k equal to 1 by 16, so 1 by 4 x minus 1 whole cube when x greater than 1 and less than equal to 3 and 0 otherwise. So this is an example when cumulative distribution function, and we can find probability density function. So today is sufficient for this one, and next time we can see the expectation, variance and mean of a random variables.